All right, good morning. For those of you who I've not had the pleasure of meeting, I'm Ms. Carpenter, and I had the privilege of teaching these first graders this year with Ms. Feeney and Mr. Pettway. Just one quick housekeeping thing before we get started. If you are a student speaker at the beginning of the program, Mrs. Rashid has graciously offered to serve as our co-host, and she is going to be in charge of unmuting and remuting the speaker, so you don't have to worry about that. And if you just came in and you didn't hear, if you are a student, if you could please make sure that your display name has your first and last name so that Mrs. Rashid can spotlight you when you receive your award. So again, welcome. I know that these are unusual circumstances, but I'm so grateful that we can be together this morning on Zoom to celebrate your students' accomplishments. And at this time, without further ado, I'm going to hand the program over to some of our students. Bailey.
Welcome to our Awards Day program. We are so glad that you could be here with us today. Even though we can't be together in person, we are excited to celebrate our achievements and accomplishments. Thank you for coming, and again, welcome.
Thank you for that warm welcome, Bailey. Now please join me in reciting the Drew Charter School Creed. I am a Drewy Google. I am smart, unique, and special. I believe in doing my best and being my best at all times. I am respectful, responsible, and resourceful. I value the importance of my education. Therefore, I come to school every day determined, equipped, and ready to learn. I look for positive solutions and respect the rights of others. I work hard to achieve my goals and demonstrate the attributes of a high-achieving student. I make a difference. I soar. I am a Drew Eagle.
Today we'll be receiving awards for Best Honor Roll and Perfect Attendance. Before we receive our awards, we will enjoy a piano performance by Riley C.
For that beautiful performance, Riley. We just have such talented students. Today, we are excited to celebrate your students' hard work and accomplishments in first grade. We will give each student a Teacher's Choice Award. We will also list the students that received Principal's List, all A's, Honor Roll, all A's and B's, and Perfect Attendance. No absences, and no more than two tardy. Mr. Pettway is going to begin the presentation of awards in alphabetical order.
Our first award for Miss McKinsley Brown. She is receiving the Storytelling Sensation Award, whether it's straight from the pages of her favorite authors or from the unique imagination of McKinsley herself, you know you're going to be in for a good one. Her energy and enthusiasm have held us all captive as listeners, and we love her for her ability to share stories. Keep sharing those stories, girl. McKinsley is also being recognized for honor roll. Next, we have Caden Creighton. So much can be said about Caden Creighton, but today he is receiving the King of Kindness Award. You could drop your pen on the complete opposite side of the classroom, and within seconds, you'll have Caden in front of you asking to help you pick up the pen. Whether it was a new hairstyle I came in the room with, a matching outfit from Ms. Carpenter and Ms. Feeney, or any work his classmates have done, Caden is coming with a compliment. There is no friend left behind when Caden is around. His kindness has definitely settled in all of our hearts. Thank you, Caden. Riley Crisp is receiving the Star Reader Award. Now, I know I'm a pretty good reader, but Riley Crisp may not be far behind me. Every time we had a reading test, Riley would put my timer to shame, and she would challenge herself to do better and better. Thank you, Riley, for setting such a great example for your classmates and being a phenomenal reader. Riley is also being recognized for the principal's list. Harper is receiving the Marvelous Mathematician Award. If there is a problem to solve, Harper is on the case. His natural competitiveness comes through with how quickly he can solve a problem, and he is always happy to help out a classmate. Keep adding those numbers up, Harper. Harper is being recognized for the principal's list and perfect attendance. He is also being recognized by Ms. Britt for his outstanding performance in technology. Gabby is receiving the Right Hand Woman Award. Gabby is always ready and willing to assist with whatever her teachers need, whether it's her work or even sometimes ours. We may be doing a million things at once, and then here comes Gabby with an almost mother-like charm asking if we need help. If you need a reminder on what time it is, Gabby is there. If her classmates need help finding something, Gabby is there. And if you just need a pat on the back from an exhaustive day of teaching, guess what? Gabby is there. Thank you for being there when anyone needed you, Gabby. Gabby is also being recognized by Ms. Rector for the Quick-Witted and Compassionate RTI Readers Comprehension Award, as well as the honor roll. Karen. Karen is receiving the Athletic Eagle Award. If I ever needed an update on any sports game throughout the week, I could be sure that Karen had the news. When it came time for us to talk about our weekend plans, we knew Karen would be either at the Falcons game, Atlanta United, or Hawks game. And somewhere in that weekend, he'll definitely be working on his soccer skills. If you need to find Karen on the playground, it's not too hard. He's either shooting hoops, running around with the football, or aiming his kick for the soccer goal. Karen is a competitor, but you can tell by his engagement with his friends that he is a good teammate and classmate as well. Stay in the game, Karen. Karen is also being recognized for principal's list, perfect attendance, and chess club.
Thank you, Mr. Pettway. Brooklyn is receiving the Happy Helper Award because of her care and compassion for others. Brooklyn loves to help her teachers as well as her classmates. She was always there to lend a helping hand or give encouraging words to her friends. Brooklyn, your teachers truly couldn't get through the day without your help. I mean that. Brooklyn is being recognized for principal's list. She is also being recognized by Ms. Britt for her outstanding achievement in technology. Don Haley. John is receiving the Ray of Sunshine Award because we could always count on John to make us smile. John has such a sweet and sunny personality. He always brightened my day, and I know that countless others feel the same way. John always made us laugh during sharing time at morning meeting, talking about his love of video games. John, thank you for making our classroom a happier and more joyful place. John is also being recognized for honor roll. Scarlett. Scarlett is receiving the Enthusiastic Learner Award for always being excited about learning and taking on new challenges. You blew me away this year with your mental math strategies and the way that you explain your thinking, Scarlett. I loved your curiosity and your dedication to learning and trying new things. I know that these traits will take you far, both inside and outside of the classroom. Scarlett is also being recognized for Principal's List. Elijah is receiving the Computer Genius Award for his expertise when it comes to all things technology. Elijah loved to work hard to earn extra time on the computer, and he liked to help his classmates and teachers with our computers and tablets. As we all know, this is a very important skill, especially during virtual learning. Keep up the great work, Elijah. We are so proud of you. Ruby Rashid is receiving the Future Teacher Award because she demonstrates so many attributes of a great teacher. She is kind, patient, fair, hardworking, organized, and she loves to help others. I could always count on Ruby to be my assistant, whether it was making me coffee or monitoring Kinderlime in the afternoons. Ruby, no matter what you decide to do when you grow up, I know that you're going to make a difference in this world. Ruby is also being recognized for Principal's List. My other Ruby, Ruby Reinold. Ruby Reinold is receiving the Peacekeeper Award because she showed kindness and compassion to all of her classmates. She is a great listener and a wonderful friend. Ruby could tell when a classmate or a teacher was feeling down, and she was always there with kind words or a hug. Ruby, you helped our classroom be a calm, safe, and loving place for everyone, and we are so appreciative of that. Ruby Reinold is also being recognized for Principal's List.
Next up is Bailey. Bailey is receiving the Bright Ideas Award for her out-of-box thinking and brainstorming in our class this year. We loved hearing the ideas Bailey would come up with for classroom projects, PBL units, and during our EL reading block. We especially remember the vital part Bailey played in creating and selling the Drew coasters. She helped us with every step to make them a huge success. We could always count on Bailey to be engaged and contribute wonderful ideas. Bailey is also being recognized for Principal's List and perfect attendance. Riley C. Riley is receiving the Future Author Award for all her hard work in our classroom this year. During our reading and writing block, Riley always impressed us with her dedication to writing and taking her time to produce quality pieces. We also loved the detailed illustrations she would add. When we were in Daily Five Centers, we loved seeing her creative juices flow as she independently wrote journal entries and short stories. She loved to show her teachers her work when the round was done. Riley is also being recognized for Principal's List. London. London is receiving the Social Butterfly Award this year. London is a loyal friend, an encouraging classmate, and respectful to all. London has an incredible way of relating to everyone in our class and finding a connection with them. London, you have never met a stranger. You are bubbly and outgoing to everyone you meet. Thank you for being such a positive role model for our class. London is also being recognized for honor roll. Mason. Mason is receiving the King of Curiosity Award this year. We loved seeing your engagement on the carpet, in small groups, field trips, and during e-learning. We can always tell you are participating, you're focused, and you're thinking of follow-up questions to learn even more. We loved how after a read aloud, you would be the first hand up to ask more about the character's motive or a question about the plot. We also loved how you would go a step further and think about how you would have done something differently than the character, and that would have resulted in a different outcome. Thank you, Mason, for keeping us all curious and asking deeper questions. Victoria. Victoria is receiving the Character Counts Award for no matter what, displaying incredible character throughout the school year. If we were on a normal schedule, if a teacher left the room, if we had a change of plans, if we converted to e-learning with Google Classroom, Victoria always displayed traits of integrity, respect, high morals, and thoughtfulness to other people in that moment. We could always count on Victoria to be a leader, be a role model, and to be an all-around all-star. Victoria is also being recognized for Principal's List. Feeney. Feeney is receiving the Creative Genius Award for bringing a unique, artistic, and always creative voice to our classroom. That is exactly why we asked you to create some artwork for this award ceremony, and let me say, you did an incredible job. Feeney, we loved seeing you connect your schoolwork to your creative side. My favorite example of this was when we had our near doubles math chant, and you learned the words faster than me and were reminding me of the lyrics. Or when we used Jack and the Beanstalk to help learn measurement. I love the pictures and notes of encouragement you made for me over the year, and I still keep them on my fridge. Feeney is also being recognized for honor roll. Congrats, everyone.
All right, guys, let's give our students a muted round of applause here. We are so proud of you. Now that all of our students have been recognized, let's take a look at some of our favorite memories from throughout the school year.
The clouds, whoa, oh, 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 oh. I stretch my hands out to the sky. We dance with monsters through the night. Whoa, oh, 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 oh. I'm never gonna look back. Whoa, I'm never gonna give it up. No, please don't wake me now.
2, 3, 4.
This is gonna be the best day of my life. How we'll let the moon with friends, and then the
Okay. Okay. Sorry about that, guys. We have had a fabulous year full of learning and fun. Let's listen to a couple of students share their favorite memories from this school year.
Hey, my name is John Haley, and my favorite memory is a Christmas party.
Hi, my name is Helani, and my favorite memory is with Kids Dress Up Day, because I got to dress up as Fancy Nancy, and I really like Fancy Nancy.
My favorite memory from first grade was going to the world of Coca-Cola.
My name is Colin, and I have two favorite memories. Watching a movie at Christmas and eating at Thanksgiving.
Hi. My favorite memory was the world of Coca-Cola at the drink. My first Coke, it tastes so good.
My favorite memory is the world of Coca-Cola.
Memory of first grade is meeting new teachers and having new friends. And my favorite trip is going to the world of Coca-Cola.
My favorite memory of this year is when we went to the world of Coca-Cola.
My favorite memory was when we went to the Childhood Nature Center.
My favorite memory was when we went to Coca-Cola.
My favorite memory in Ms. Carpenter's class is when we get to pick out our books, and we also get to sit wherever we want in the reading area.
My favorite memory of first grade was going to World of Coca-Cola with my friends.
My favorite memory was going to the world of Coca-Cola. I like drinking the Cokes, and I like when we took the picture with the polar bear, and I like the 3D theater.
As you can see, the world of Coca-Cola was a very popular trip. And now we're going to pass it over to Mr. Pettway.
Okay, so this has been an amazing year. It's been a pleasure working with Ms. Carpenter and Ms. Feeney and you amazing students. I've known some of you guys since last year in kindergarten, so it's been really amazing seeing you guys progress from then to now. And I just wanted to share a poem with you guys that just reminds us to think about first grade. You're all ready for a new challenge, second grade that is, but let us not forget this year and all the things we did. We learned about consumers and services we could provide. We took a trip to the Nature Center, saw an owl with our very own eyes. We became much better readers, and with math, we've all done wonders. You've played so hard at recess, you'd have thought it was already summer. And Richmond was always a ball, and we'll miss playing games with you all. But most of all, what we really want is to see you succeed next fall. I'll miss our Friday chant, where Ms. Carpenter led the way, and rewarding you all with treats that Ms. Feeney had to give away. Sadly, our year took a turn, couldn't be near each other in the end. But with e-learning, we learned new skills and a new way to connect with our friends. As we close the year, there's one thing we should all do. Take our time and remember, first grade at Drew.
Thank you so much, Mr. Pettway. And now you will have a charge from your principal, Mrs. O'Neill. Thank you.
grade students, before we close out today's program, let's take a minute and thank the individuals who helped you make it this far. At this time, I want you to thank your parents and family members for making sure you made it to school each day before the closure, for helping you commit to your online studies, and for trusting us with your learning every day. It's now time to recognize your teachers, as well as all the Drew staff that have helped shape your learning this year. Students, I want to personally congratulate all of you for an awesome first grade year. And while we did not end our school year physically in the building, you still accomplished a lot. Did you know this year you have spent more than 5,000 minutes in RTI? More than 12,000 minutes focused on literacy, another 12,000 minutes learning math, for 4,100 minutes at recess, another 4,100 minutes eating lunch with friends in the cafeteria, and over 9,000 minutes in enrichment classes. You took 4 physical field trips and 9 virtual field trips and visited places including the World of Coca-Cola and the Chattahoochee Nature Center. Through PBL, you studied climate change and ways to make our community healthier. If I had to choose one word to describe your class this year, I would choose dedicated. Not only were you dedicated to your studies in our school building, you have also been dedicated while having to learn virtually. And learning virtually is no easy task. It's something each of you should be proud of. I am confident you are all well prepared for the challenges and adventures you will be presented with in second grade. Over the summer, I want you to make sure you take a break from technology, relax, read, brush up on your math facts, and most importantly, have some fun. Class of 2031, thank you for a wonderful year, and it is now time for you to be recognized.
Okay. Well, thank you so much for attending our Awards Day program. This is a truly unique and wonderful group of children. The 2019-2020 school year is a year that none of our students will ever forget, I'm sure. When the students look back on their first grade year, I know that they will remember this global pandemic and virtual learning. But I am also certain that they will remember carpet time, read alouds, science experiments, math games, holiday parties, field trips, recess, group hugs, and many, many friends. The elementary school classroom is a very special place. Day in and day out, we share a space, knowledge, hopes, joys, disappointments, and many parts of ourselves. Even though we were not able to go back to school for the last 9 weeks, the community that we built and the love that we share for one another is not housed within the walls of our classroom. It is always in our hearts and our minds. Boys and girls, your teachers are so, so, so proud of you. You have shown perseverance during this uncertain time. You have learned so much this year and grown in so many ways. We have watched you become fluent readers, thoughtful mathematicians, and curious scientists. We are never going to forget you, so you better come and see us next year. You are all getting a huge, real-life, not virtual hug. Parents, we want to thank you from the bottom of our hearts for entrusting us with a piece of yours. It is not easy to place your child's care in the hands of another. And it has been an absolute joy and privilege to play such an important role in your child's life this year. We know that you are also not expecting to become at-home teachers in March, and we are grateful for your patience, your diligence, and your dedication to virtual learning. So to our class of 2031, congratulations. You are officially second graders. I'm going to play a song here and share another piece of artwork from Felani Young. Feel free to leave messages in the chat as we close. Thank you so much for coming. And again, congratulations.